Hi guys, I'm George and welcome to Indian Pencil Drawing. Hope you're all doing good. So in the last video, we left with the eyes, nose and the lips areas. So today I'm going to show you how to draw the mustache, beard and how to shade the cheeks and the chin areas. So when it comes to the blending process, there are two types of shading. One is the normal shading where you can use a HB pencil or 2B pencil and later on you can blend it with the blending stumps or the earbuds. The one I'm going to show in this video is the realistic skin texture kind of shading, where you need lot of patience and you need to scribble the areas where you need these textures. So like the last video, I'm uploading the real time footage along with this video so that you can get an idea how to draw the realistic skin texture. I don't need to want to talk more. So without any delay, let's get started. Comes to mustache and beard, there are a lot of small dots inside the large hair, and it's necessary to highlight in the drawing to get realistic look. I know we can't draw as shown in the picture as it is, but it's easy to scribble towards the mustache angle goes most towards. In this picture, the mustache moves towards the diagonal angle and just scribble towards the angle it goes. Then there are a lot of small pores around the mustache and beard on human skin, and I'll show you how to render it. Same on mustache, even in beard, there are small dots and pores inside the bungee hairs, but we are not going to highlight that in the portrait. Here the reference image has a patchy beard where it is an easy task to draw. When it comes to bungee beard, we are going to have lot of hair around the face, and in case if you are portraying an older person, you may need to draw white hairs on the beard. I'll be doing a separate video on showing the technique on drawing white beards. Drawing a patchy beard is always an easy job, but still if you look at closer, you can see few hard strokes where you can find thicker hair in between the patchy beards. So the pencil I used on the beard portions are 2B, 4B and 9B for the thicker hair portions. In case if you don't have a 9B pencil, you can always use a 8B or 6B pencil by just giving little pressure onto the paper. There are small areas where you would need to leave empty because the portrait would have a small glare portions. Shading your drawing is always an important part of the portrait. I have seen people who don't shade or blend the areas of the portrait where it should be shaded. Most of the people just draw the eyes, nose, lips and ears and leave the shading process behind. I always recommend you to shade the picture because only then it can be called as a portrait. I know some people get scared to shade, thinking whether the portrait would go wrong. I can understand the mentality of such people, as once even I was at the same position where I was scared of shading the cheeks and skin. But it's always your confidence on attempting new things. As you can see, the realistic skin texture is so easy, as we all need to do is just scribble. Scribble the areas you need to shade, but be careful on the angle you are scribbling. You can find the nature of the scribbling in the real-time footage attached. Please don't scribble on the drawing deliberately. The way I meant scribbling is to give an idea to all of you how the realistic skin textures look like. It always depends on your skill on understanding skin textures on the human skin. We have hair at the forehead portion left remaining. I'll show you that in the next video.
As of now, I'm wrapping up this video. So in the next video, I'll show you how to draw the hair and the forehead portions. Hope you can make use of this video. If you found yourself that this kind of tutorial can help you better, please give me a like and please share this video to your friends, whoever is learning how to draw. Also, please comment what kind of tutorials you would like to watch more. It will be helpful for me to make more videos. Also, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Anyways, thanks for watching this video. I'll talk to you in the next one. Bye.